When I was first learning about GraphQL, I had some wrong assumptions about what it was and what I could do with it. First up, I thought GraphQL was a database. I knew about SQL and MySQL and NoSQL, which are all related to databases. So wouldn't GraphQL be the same? I think it's a pretty fair first impression, but actually GraphQL is not a database. It doesn't store data. Instead, it gives us a picture of what we can do with our data. And this data can come from totally different places, including databases. Second, I thought I needed to know JavaScript. GraphQL was started by Facebook, and at that time, it was pretty well used in the React community. So that meant JavaScript, right? Well, we might have started with JavaScript, but now GraphQL has come a long way, and we can implement it in a bunch of different programming languages, like Python, Java, C#, Ruby, and more. No matter which language you use, there's lots of GraphQL libraries and frameworks to make this easy. Third, I thought I had to drop all of my existing REST architecture to use GraphQL. There were so many blogs and articles about GraphQL versus REST. And I get it, it's tempting to pit technologies against each other. But turns out, we don't need that drama. I could actually use GraphQL alongside my existing REST APIs and databases, saving me from having to throw away a lot of work. GraphQL was a really helpful layer on top, the one single endpoint that API consumers could interact with, instead of having to wrangle data from all these different sources. I hope that helped clear up some incorrect assumptions you maybe had about GraphQL. And if you're curious to learn more about what it actually is and what it can do for you, head over to our learning platform, Odyssey.